Good morning, everybody, and thanks for joining us here on the web. Bristol police are searching for a man and woman they believe created a meth lab inside an apartment building there. The lab was discovered yesterday afternoon. Police say the suspects, Chris Corum and Cheryl Fisher, should be considered armed and dangerous. Fire officials in Manchester are investigating a pair of suspicious fires. The most recent was set overnight at a shed on Pine Lane. Officials say the flames spread to a nearby home and car, causing between $20,000 and $30,000 in damage. On Monday, another suspicious fire was set to a shed directly across the street on Hazel Lane. With less than a week to go before the primary, the Democratic candidates for governor faced off in our first Granite State debate last night. Jackie Silly, Maggie Hassan, and Bill Kennedy kicked things off by explaining why they are running for the governor's office.
I bring a fresh perspective. I bring a nonpartisan perspective. I bring an appeal, I believe, to both sides.
I have a plan to stop the Tea Party, begin reversing the damage, and then build our economy, strengthening our education system.
And I am the only one in this race who actually has legitimate business experience. I know what it takes to operate a business. I know what it takes to bring people through the doors. And I also know what it takes to stimulate an economy.
And tonight, Republican candidates Ovid LaMontagne and Kevin Smith will have their chance to face off. Their debate starts at 7 p.m. You can watch it on WMUR-TV or here on our website, WMUR.com. Meantime, both President Obama and Mitt Romney will hold campaign events here in New Hampshire tomorrow. Romney will hold a rally in Nashua at Holman Stadium. The doors open at 4:30 p.m. Earlier in the day, President Obama will be at Strawberry Bank in Portsmouth, along with the First Lady, Vice President Biden, and his wife, Dr. Jill Biden. Ticket information for both events can be found here on our website, WMUR.com. And that's it for this webcast. We hope you can join us for News 9 at noon, and you can check out our next webcast around 1 this afternoon. Have a great day, everybody.